Hello and welcome to In Depth. I'm Tina Jha. As India's premier investigating agency, the Central Bureau of Investigation, or the CBI, handles all high-profile cases. Its job is to ensure a fair and an impartial probe. But in recent days, the agency has been in the news for all the wrong reasons. Two of the top officials of the agency, Director Alok Verma and Special Director Rakesh Asthana, are involved in a major feud that has forced the government to intervene. Both officers have been sent on leave, with the government claiming that the decision was taken to restore the institutional integrity and credibility of CBI. Today in In-Depth, we take a look at the reasons that triggered differences between the two senior-most CBI officers. We also try to understand the process of appointments in the CBI and the powers granted to the agency. The government action against the two warring CBI officers came after a high-voltage drama in the Delhi High Court. Special Director Rakesh Asthana sought quashing of charges against him as well as protection from arrest, while the CBI alleged that an extortion racket had been going on in the garb of investigating high-profile cases. In this report, let's look at the genesis of the current crisis. Amid grave allegations of corruption against senior functionaries of the Central Bureau of Investigation, the government stepped in on Wednesday and appointed M. Nageshwar Rao as interim chief of the investigating agency with immediate effect. The appointments committee of the cabinet, led by Prime Minister Narendra Modi, gave charge of the CBI to Joint Director M. Nageshwar Rao and Odisha Cadre officer. CBI Director Alok Verma and Special Director Rakesh Asthana were sent on leave. They were also divested of all powers amid an ongoing spat. Finance Minister Arun Jaitley said the government's decision to remove Alok Verma and Rakesh Asthana was based on the recommendations of the Chief Vigilance Commission, asserting that it was essential to restore the CBI's institutional integrity and credibility.
एक विचित्र और दुर्भाग्यपूर्ण स्थिति पैदा हुई है। वो स्थिति ये है कि सीबीआई के दो बड़े अधिकारी डायरेक्टर और स्पेशल डायरेक्टर मैं विषयों के मेरिट पे नहीं जाता कि कौन सही है कौन गलत है ये जांच का विषय है स्पेशल डायरेक्टर का एक आरोप डायरेक्टर के ऊपर है सीबीआई का आरोप स्पेशल डायरेक्टर के ऊपर है तो सीबीआई के दो बड़े अधिकारी सबसे बड़े अधिकारी जो हैं उन दोनों पे आरोप है अब इसकी जांच कौन करेगा द रिक्वायरमेंट्स ऑफ फेयरनेस And fair play have to be there. ये सरकार के अधिकार क्षेत्र में नहीं आता सरकार उसकी जांच नहीं कर सकती और न करेगी सीबीआई का जो एक्ट है उस कानून के तहत सेंट्रल विजिलेंस कमीशन के पावर अधिकार है सेक्शन 4(1) में Power of superintendence in relation to investigative functions. तो CBI की investigations के संबंध में जो superintendence का अधिकार है वो Central Vigilance Commission का है.
The finance minister said the CVC received details of the charges that both officers leveled against each other. According to him, the CVC recommended that accused or potential accused cannot be allowed to be in charge of investigation against them. Jaitley clarified that the government had no role to play in the matter.
CVC के पास वो सारा material है जो एक दूसरे के ऊपर आरोप लगे और कल Central Vigilance Commission ने अपनी meeting में Section 8 CVC Act और सेक्शन 4(1) ऑफ द दिल्ली स्पेशल पुलिस एस्टैब्लिशमेंट एक्ट के तहत ये सिफारिश की कि इन आरोपों की जांच ना तो ये दो अधिकारी कर सकते हैं क्योंकि इन दोनों पे स्वयं आरोप है और न ही इनकी सुपरविजन में कोई एजेंसी कर सकती है। इसलिए जब तक इसकी जांच होगी टू मेंटेन द इंस्टीट्यूशनल इंटेग्रिटी ऑफ द सीबीआई एंड इन द इंटरेस्ट ऑफ फेयरनेस प्योरली एज एन इंटरिम मेजर दे विल सिट आउट बाय गोइंग ऑन लीव फॉर अ सर्टन पीरियड ऑफ टाइम। इट्स एन इंटरिम मेजर and an SIT not functioning under either of these two officers will investigate the case.
A special investigation team will look into the charges and both officers will sit out the duration of the probe. The spat between Alok Verma and Rakesh Asthana is the first of its kind in the history of CBI. It became public when Verma objected to the elevation of then additional director Rakesh Asthana as special director before the Central Vigilance Commission. Although the objections were noted, the commission in a unanimous decision cleared Asthana as special director, making him the second in command in the agency. A PIL filed by NGO Common Cause against the decision was also rejected by the Supreme Court. Rakesh Asthana, who was in charge of the special investigation team handling sensitive cases including those related to Vijay Mallya, Agusta Westland and land acquisition in Haryana, filed a complaint against Alok Verma on 24th August, alleging that he took a bribe of 2 crore rupees from an accused investigated by him. Asthana also complained about 10 more cases of alleged corruption and irregularities against the director. He even alleged that Verma had tried to stop raids against RJD Supremo Lalu Prasad Yadav. The matter was referred by the government to the Central Vigilance Commission, which sought files of cases mentioned in Asthana's complaint. In his response, Verma told the CVC that Asthana's role was under probe in at least 6 cases, including one related to the loan default by Gujarat-based Sterling Biotech. He also told the commission that in his absence, his second-in-command Asthana cannot represent in panel meetings. Asthana then urged the government to intervene, seeking an independent probe into the allegations levelled by Verma and the cases in which his role was being alleged. While communications between Verma, Asthana and the CVC were being exchanged, they also found way into the media and reports of the first of its kind spat in the top brass of the agency were out in public glare.
What has happened is most unfortunate. It has caused irreparable damage to the CBI. I don't know how the CBI reputation as an impartial, efficient investigation agency under the central government will be retrieved, restored. I don't know that. This has never happened before. Such a thing has never happened before. It's the first time that such events have, when the top two have fought against each other. A criminal case, a corruption case has been registered. FIR has been lodged, a case has been registered against number 2, Special Director CBI. This has never happened before.
The feud between the two top officers escalated when, in an unprecedented move, the CBI registered an FIR against Special Director Rakesh Asthana on 15th October for allegedly taking a bribe from an accused probed by him in lieu of ensuring relief and a clean sheet in the case. The case was registered on a statement of the alleged bribe giver Satish Sana, who was facing probe in a separate case of bribery involving meat exporter Moin Qureshi. The CBI also arrested Devinder Kumar, a deputy SP in Rakesh Asthana's team. However, Asthana, in his complaint against the CBI director 2 months ago, had alleged that it was Sana who paid Alok Verma 2 crore rupees to get relief. The internecine battle between the two CBI officers reached the judicial arena. Rakesh Asthana approached the Delhi High Court seeking quashing the agency's FIR against him. The court directed the CBI to maintain status quo on the criminal proceedings initiated against Asthana till the 29th of October, but clarified there was no stay on the ongoing probe considering the nature and gravity of the case. Now, as the investigation against two senior-most officers is on course, the CBI overhauled the team probing allegations of corruption against Rakesh Asthana. According to news reports, changes have been made from the investigation officer to supervisory levels. Bureau report, Rajya Sabha TV. The process to appoint the CBI director has seen several changes over the years. Currently, the appointment is carried out as per the Lokpal Act of 2014 by a committee headed by the Prime Minister. In this report, we take a look at the appointment process and the functions of the investigating agency.
The CBI is headed by a director who is an IPS officer of the rank of Director General of Police. The process of appointment of the CBI chief has gone through several changes over the years. Before the Lokpal Act was enacted in 2014, the appointment was made on the basis of the Delhi Special Police Establishment Act of 1946. The DSPE Act was revised in 2003 on the Supreme Court's recommendation so as to make the process of appointing the agency's director transparent. Under the DSPE Act, the central government formed a commission headed by the Chief Vigilance Commissioner. The committee had members from the Central Vigilance Commission, secretaries from the Home Ministry and the Ministry of Personnel and Public Grievances. The committee sent its recommendations to the central government, which would then appoint the CBI director. However, after the Lokpal Act came into force in 2014, the appointment process underwent a change. The Lokpal Act of 2014 provides for an empowered committee for the appointment of the CBI director. The committee is headed by the Prime Minister and has the Leader of Opposition as its member. It also has the Chief Justice of India or a Supreme Court judge recommended by the Chief Justice as its member.
पहले director का selection का process था कि ये जो CVC हैं और दो VC होते हैं और ये secretary personal और home secretary पांच लोग बैठ के सब नाम वो examine करते थे जो eligible हैं. उसमें से फिर वो तीन का नाम रेकमेंड करते थे गवर्नमेंट को और जो तीन नाम वो रेकमेंड करते थे उसमें से गवर्नमेंट किसी को भी चूज़ कर सकती थी. ये पुराना प्रोसीजर था. पर जब से ये लोकपाल एक्ट आया है तो अब सीबीआई का डायरेक्टर का सिलेक्शन पीएम, लीडर ऑफ ऑपोजिशन और चीफ जस्टिस करते हैं.
द प्रोसेस बिगिंस इन द होम मिनिस्ट्री दैट प्रिपेयर्स अ लिस्ट ऑफ आईपीएस ऑफिसर्स एलिजिबल फॉर द पोस्ट. The Home Ministry list is sent to the Department of Personnel and Training. A final list is prepared on the basis of seniority, integrity and experience in investigating anti-corruption cases. The list then goes to the committee headed by the Prime Minister. The government appoints the Director of the Central Bureau of Investigation.
Director as head of the organization, sare ke sare power hai unke paas. Ab unlimited powers to kisi ke paas nahi hai. Hamesha चेक एंड बैलेंस रहता है सरकारी काम में. डायरेक्टर के पावर पर सीबीसी का भी निगरानी रहता है और फिर कोर्ट के तभी प्रति भी दायित्व है सरकार डायरेक्टर सीबीआई का या सीबीआई का. लेकिन सीबीआई के हेड है, ऑल इन ऑल है वो. काम का बंटवारा, अधिकारियों का चयन, किस केस के लिए कौन ऑफिसर अधिकारी करेगा, ये सब फाइनल अथॉरिटी सीबीआई का डायरेक्टर है.
CBI draws its powers from the DSPE Act of 1946. The centre may extend to any area besides union territories the powers and jurisdiction of members of the CBI for investigation. The areas that fall under the scope of CBI's investigation are cases essentially against central government employees or concerning the affairs of the central government, cases in which financial interests of the central government are involved, cases relating to breaches of central laws, big cases of fraud, cheating and embezzlement, cases committed by organized gangs or professional criminals having ramifications in several states, cases having interstate and international ramifications. Bureau report, Rajya Sabha TV.
And now let's tell you how the CBI came into existence. During the Second World War, the government formed a special police establishment in 1941 to investigate war-related bribery and corruption cases. After the war ended, the SPE was assigned to investigate bribery and corruption cases for the central government involving the government employees. The SPE was renamed Central Bureau of Investigation in 1963, and with time, its jurisdiction spread to cover various other departments.
India's premier investigation agency, the Central Bureau of Investigation, operates under the jurisdiction of the Ministry of Personnel, Public Grievances and Pensions. Headquartered in New Delhi, the agency is headed by a director. The CBI traces its origin to the Special Police Establishment set up in 1941 by the Government of India. Its functions then included investigation of bribery and corruption cases in transactions with the War and Supply Department during World War II. After the war ended, the government set up a central investigation agency to investigate cases of bribery and corruption by central government employees. In 1946, the Delhi Special Police Establishment Act was brought into force. The Act transferred the superintendence of the SPE to the Home Ministry and its functions were enlarged to cover all government departments. The jurisdiction of the SPE extended to all Union Territories and could be extended also to states with the consent of the state government. The DSPE was rechristened the Central Bureau of Investigation in 1963.
सरकार के पास कोई एंटी करप्शन यूनिट नहीं था तो ये 1940s में वॉर के बाद ये सेटअप हुआ था दिल्ली पुलिस एस्टैब्लिशमेंट एक्ट के नाम से और इसका मेन पर्पस था कि जो वॉर टाइम में जो बहुत सारे कॉन्ट्रैक्ट्स दिए गए थे और बहुत सारा सरप्लस डिफेंस इक्विपमेंट परचेज किया गया था तो उसके जो भी फ्रॉड्स हो रहे थे उसको इन्वेस्टिगेट करने के लिए
Initially, the offences notified by the central government related only to corruption by central government employees. But in due course, employees of public sector undertakings, public sector banks also came within the CBI's ambit. The CBI was entrusted with the investigation of economic offences and important conventional crimes like murders, kidnappings, terrorist crimes on a selective basis from 1965.
इसका रोल है कि सेंट्रल गवर्नमेंट के जो भी एजेंसीज हैं उसमें विजिलेंस का काम सीबीआई करती है मतलब इन्वेस्टिगेशन का काम जो भी केसेस करप्शन के केसेस सेंट्रल गवर्नमेंट एम्प्लॉयज़ के अगेंस्ट हैं वो सीबीआई इन्वेस्टिगेट करती है और स्टेट से भी जब रिक्वेस्ट आते हैं केसेस के तो सीबीआई उन केसेस को लेती है और सुप्रीम कोर्ट और हाई कोर्ट कोई केस का इन्वेस्टिगेशन ऑर्डर करे तो सीबीआई उसको भी इन्वेस्टिगेट करती है
In 1987, CBI was divided into two investigation divisions, the Anti-Corruption Division that dealt only with cases of corruption and the Special Crimes Division dealing with cases of conventional crimes besides economic offences. The CBI network comprises of 10 regional zones, Mumbai looking after Maharashtra, Gujarat and Goa, the Hyderabad zone for Andhra Pradesh, Telangana, Karnataka, Chennai zone looking after the states of Tamil Nadu, Kerala and the Union Territory of Pondicherry, Guwahati zone for Assam, Arunachal Pradesh, Manipur, Mizoram, Meghalaya, Nagaland and Tripura, Kolkata zone for the states of West Bengal, Odisha and Port Blair, Patna zone for Bihar and Jharkhand, Lucknow for Uttar Pradesh and Uttarakhand, Chandigarh for Punjab, Haryana, Himachal Pradesh and Jammu and Kashmir, Bhopal zone for Madhya Pradesh and Chhattisgarh and Delhi which covers Rajasthan and NCR. Other divisions are Anti-Corruption Headquarters Zone, Economic Offences Zone 1 and 2, Bank Security and Fraud Zone, Special Crimes Zone, Special Task Force Zone, Multidisciplinary Monitoring Agency, Policy Division, Technical Forensic and Coordination Zone and the Central Forensic Science Laboratory. At present, the CBI is headed by a director who is an IPS officer with the rank of Director General of Police. The director has a term of 2 years. The other police ranks in CBI are Special Director, Additional Director, Joint Director, Deputy Inspector General of Police, Inspector, Sub-Inspector, Assistant Sub-Inspector, Head Constable and Constable which are recruited through SSC or through deputation from Police, Income Tax Department and Customs Department. The CBI has established a reputation for competence. The High Courts and the Supreme Court also have the jurisdiction to order a CBI investigation into an offence alleged to have been committed in a state without the state's consent. It is also exempted from the provisions of the Right to Information Act. This exemption was granted by the government in 2011. Bureau Report, Rajya Sabha TV.
We often read or hear about cases being investigated either by the CBI or by the CID, the two investigating agencies in the country. But not many of us know the difference between the two. Both agencies are endowed with huge responsibilities of investigating crucial matters that involve the state or the entire country. Here's a detailed report on the basic difference between the two.
There are two premier investigative agencies in India, the CBI or Central Bureau of Investigation and the CID or Crime Investigation Department. The CID operates at the state level and has limited powers, while the CBI operates at the national level and is involved in cases that require wider investigation. Their style of functioning is quite different too. CID or the Crime Investigation Department is an investigation and intelligence department of the state police. It involves high level of investigation in cases of murder, assault, riots or any offence committed within the state. CID was established in 1902 by the British government. Cases are handed over to the CID by the state government, but there are times when the High Court of the concerned state also assigns them cases for investigation. On the other hand, the CBI is an agency of the central government and can investigate crimes committed across the nation. CBI was established in 1941 as a special police establishment and it was named the Central Bureau of Investigation in April 1963. It has its headquarters in New Delhi. The central government can authorize the CBI to investigate certain cases in the state with the consent of the state government. The Supreme Court and the High Courts can also order the CBI to investigate a crime in any state of the country without the consent of the state government.
CID is state police ka hissa hai, Rajya police ka hissa hai. CBI kendriya sarkar ke tahat sabse premier investigating agency hai. Iska nirman 1964 mein Lal Bahadur Shastri ne karwaya tha. Ek 57 committee bani thi. जिसको कहा गया कि भ्रष्टाचार से कैसे कैसे लड़ाई की जा सकती है और वो एमपी थे संतान और मेंबर थे उन लोगों का रिकमेंडेशन हुआ लाल बहादुर शास्त्री उसमें गृह मंत्री थे नेहरू प्रधानमंत्री थे और 64 में सीबीआई का निर्माण हुआ.
Both CID and CBI have divisions based on their tasks. The divisions within CID are anti-human trafficking and missing persons cell, anti-narcotics cell, Fingerprint Bureau and CBCID. The divisions of the CBI are Economic Offences Division, Special Crimes Division, Central Forensic Science Laboratory, Anti-Corruption Division, Policy and Coordination Division and the Directorate of Prosecution and Administration Division. However, there are several similarities between the two investigating agencies as well. Both have intelligence and investigation wings. Officers receive special training before being taken on for the job, and after graduation, a candidate has to join the police force before being part of either agency. With inputs from Vipin Chauhan, Bureau Report for Rajya Sabha TV.
And that's it from us in today's edition of In Depth. We'll be back same time tomorrow with a focus on some other subject. You can also watch our episodes online on YouTube and Twitter and get back to us with your feedback and suggestions. Thanks for your time.